When I saw sunscreen that was especially made for dry skin, I thought to myself, like, why would you make that when most of the sunscreens are already good for dry skin? Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So as you know, I recently was in Germany and I got all these Garnier sunscreens to review for you guys. And yes, you can watch the vlog right here in case you're interested. So one of the sunscreens that I got while I was there was this anti-dryness super UV sunscreen with glycerin. Now, when I was purchasing this, I mentioned in the vlog that I could not find the anti-age sunscreen and over makeup spray, and the fluid was all sold out, but the shelves were full with this one. You could find like 10 packages of this one. So for some reason, this one was not selling out. People were not buying this one. And to be honest, I think I know why. It's because they use the anti-dryness keyword, if I can call it a keyword. So the word anti-dryness usually makes me think of something heavy, greasy, oily, something for dry skin. Usually creams for dry skin are very rich and very moisturizing, sometimes oily, sometimes too heavy. So when I saw a sunscreen that was especially made for dry skin, I thought to myself, like, why would you make that when most of the sunscreens are already good for dry skin? I think that the name anti-dry is pushing the people away because they think it's going to be greasy. And that's the same thing that I thought about this sunscreen. And boy, was I wrong. Anyways, I almost didn't get to this one because I thought no one's buying this one. No one's interested in this one. It's probably greasy. I don't know, why should I get it? And then I was like, what the heck? I'm gonna buy all that I can find and then I'm going to do reviews for you guys. It might end up being useful for someone and that's it. So that's the only reason why I bought it. And boy, would I regret not buying this one. This is not greasy. I think that this is my favorite sunscreen out of all Garnier sunscreens that I have tried so far. And let me explain why. As always, let's first start with the claims. This sunscreen offers very high SPF protection while hydrating your skin up to 24 hours. Enriched with glycerin, the formula helps attract moisture and leaves the skin feeling smooth. Its light texture is comfortable to wear and offers daily hydration for dry skin without leaving a greasy finish. Now, I don't know about this 24-hour thing because I don't wear sunscreen for 24 hours. I never do that. But all the other claims are true. I tested it and yes, it's not leaving a greasy finish and is very moisturizing, very hydrated on the skin. I was pleasantly surprised when I tried this one. So yes, this does not have a greasy finish. It gives you a very well moisturized finish. And in case you had a dilemma what to apply first, sunscreen or a moisturizer, I think that this one could solve your problem because this is two in one. You have a moisturizer and a sunscreen. So avoid the problem of mixing a moisturizer with sunscreen and just get this one. Now I'm giving you my opinion a little bit too soon in the video, so wait for it. I will explain why I like this one so much. I just wanted to comment on the claims. The claims are true, and let's move on to the ingredients. The ingredient that is emphasized even in the claims is glycerin. And glycerin is a humectant that binds water really well and is going to help with preserving the hydration of your skin. So that is a great ingredient right there. So other than glycerin, I would like to mention just one more ingredient, that is isopropyl palmitate. This is a great emollient ingredient. The only problem is that it is a little bit comedogenic, but if you have dry skin, one comedogenic ingredient won't be a problem for you. This can be a problem only for people who are acne prone or, you know, have problematic skin. But then again, this is not a sunscreen for acne prone skin. So moving on with that, I just wanted to mention that yes, there is one comedogenic ingredient. But don't worry, it did not cause any problems for me. That's because I do have dry skin. So if you too have dry skin or normal, you won't have a problem with breakouts with this one. So yeah, don't worry about that. Okay, so those are all the ingredients that I would like to emphasize for you guys. There's no actives here, unlike with the anti-age Garnier sunscreen. This one, I did a review for that one. That one had three actives that were fighting the dark spots on your face. So that one had more active ingredients. Now this one does not have any active ingredients. It just has a humectant, glycerin, and emollient. So this one is supposed to, you know, just help dry skin and moisturize it. So there are no actives. So that's why I'm going to move straight away to UV filters. Now, with UV filters, this one actually has a total of 8 UV filters. Now, anti-age, Garnier anti-age sunscreen had only 5. And the spray for over makeup, also by Garnier, I also have a review, go check it out right here. That one also had only 5 UV filters. Now this one has 8, but of course that does not mean that it has a higher protection. It just has more filters, but the protection is the same. You have SPF 50 and you do have UVA protection as well, and it is broad spectrum. I mean, the same thing as with the anti-age and the over makeup spray. There's no claim on the packaging that it is broad spectrum, but on the website it says that it is broad spectrum, so I'm going to say that this one as well is broad spectrum, even though I don't know why they're not putting that on the packaging, I'm not sure. But yeah, broad spectrum means that UVA protection has to be at least 1/3 of the claimed UVB protection. I assume it's broad spectrum. I don't know. Garnier, please let me know, why do you not write the broad spectrum claim on the packaging? Please let me know that. I'm not sure. On the website, all the sunscreens are broad spectrum, but on the packaging, that claim is not emphasized, and that is a very important claim. I'm not sure what's going on there, but let's just call it broad spectrum and move on with our lives, shall we? Okay, now let's see. UV filters. As I mentioned, we have 8 UV filters. Now, the first one is homosalate. It's a not that strong UVB filter, but it's more so here to solubilize avobenzin, and we do have avobenzin in this one as well. Then the next one, we have ethyl hexyl salicylate. Again, not that strong, but it is solubilizing other UV filters. Then we have avobenzin, as I mentioned already. Now, avobenzin is a great UVA filter. The problem with avobenzin is that it is not that photostable. But then again, we do have other filters. Usually, when there is avobenzin in the sunscreen, there are 2 to 3 more other UV filters that are not that strong, but are photostable and are stabilizing avobenzin or solubilizing it. But overall, avobenzin is a great UVA filter. Then we have octacrylene. Octacrylene protects in both UVA and UV range. Not that strong, but it's quite photostable, and it is helping with stabilizing avobenzin again that I mentioned earlier. Then we have ethyl hexyl triazone, which is a great UVB filter and very photostable as well. Then we have thinosorb S, a broad spectrum sunscreen that is also very photostable. Then we have insulazole, fairly photostable, and is also helping with stabilizing avobenzin again. And then the last, but certainly not the least, is Mixoryl XL. And now this is a L'Oreal Group exclusive agent, and only L'Oreal owned companies have that one. And Garnier is also owned by L'Oreal. This one provides you with both UVA and UVB protection and is very photostable. So those are all UV filters. So we do have both UVA and UVB protection, high UVB protection, SPF 50. And yeah, moving on to controversial ingredients. Now, this one does not have fragrance, so that is great, but it does have alcohol. Now, alcohol is controversial. Some people hate it. I don't mind it, for example. I don't mind it. And in this case, when alcohol is present in sunscreen, it is going to help with creating a lightweight formulation, which this formulation is very lightweight, does not feel heavy on the skin. And reason why that is so is probably alcohol, because alcohol is used to create those cosmetically elegant formulations. And when found in serum, it's going to help with the penetration of the actives in the serum. Now, being that we do not have actives here, the purpose of this alcohol is just to create a lightweight texture. And that's why I do not mind it. And no, it does not dry out the skin, because that's the main concern that people have with alcohol in their products. They think that it's going to dry out their skin. But alcohol is not the only ingredient here. You have a lot of emollient ingredients, and most of the UV filters here are oil soluble. So in order to make a sunscreen with a bunch of oil soluble UV filters lightweight, it is necessary to add a little bit of alcohol in it. So that's just my explanation on why alcohol is here, what is it doing, how is it helping, and I don't mind it at all. And no, this sunscreen is not drying on the skin because of this alcohol. So that's it. In case you are against alcohol, maybe think about that a little bit. But in case you really, really don't like alcohol, or you're somehow sensitive to alcohol, then be warned, this sunscreen does have alcohol in it. Okay, moving on. That's it. There is no more controversial ingredients. Now let's see the demo application, how this sunscreen applies, how it feels on the skin, and what effect does it create on the skin. Okay, so I'm starting off with protecting my under eye area with the shock of fluid, and I do have a review on the sunscreen as well. You can check it out on my channel. And the reason why I'm doing that is because this sunscreen, this anti-dryness sunscreen by Garnier, also cannot be applied around the eye area. Now, once I've protected the eye area, I'm going in with the anti-dryness sunscreen. Now, as you can see here, I applied quite a lot, and that's not a problem. I mean, you should apply a decent amount of sunscreen to your face to maintain that claimed protection. The problem is that this amount was hard to blend. So that's the only thing. I would advise you to divide this in two layers if you don't want to struggle with blending. But as you can see, I blended it in the end. It's possible, but it just took me longer time to blend it. And after I did blend it, as you can see, it gave me a wonderful glow and it moisturized my skin really, really well. And as you can see here, so this is really a great sunscreen for anyone who has dry skin. And after this, I waited for around 15 minutes. And here, this is how it looks after 15 minutes once it sets. Now, I know this is a different lighting. The lighting was really messing with me that day, so you cannot really see anything, but the moisture is there and the glow went down a little bit. So I'm not greasy, I'm just slightly glowy, and I have very well moisturized skin. Now let's see the second layer. So for the second layer, I applied less because I really did apply a lot with the first layer and I did not need that much in the second layer, but I wanted to see how it layers, and that's why I did this. So anyways, it layers really well. Yes, it gives you a white cast in the beginning, but once you blend it, it's gone and there's no white cast on your face, and it gives you a little bit more glow with the second layer, more moisture, but it overall layers well. It wasn't peeling or anything, so that's a good thing about this one. It wasn't peeling. If you hated the anti-age sunscreen because it was peeling, then this one is going to be good for you. Very well moisturized skin, and yeah, no peeling, no nothing. It layers pretty well. So after this, I waited for around 15 minutes again for it to set, and this is how it looks after it sets. As you can see, the glow is a little bit toned down, but the moisture is still there, and yeah, overall I love how moisturized my skin is. Now let's see how this performs underneath makeup. As always, I'm mixing these two foundations for my skin. These give me a semi-matte finish, that's why I mix them. And this sunscreen as well acts pretty well underneath makeup, and maybe glycerin is even helping it a little bit more. And as you can see, this is the finished look. Yeah, blended pretty well, foundation looks flawless. It did mattify the sunscreen a little bit. Now I did go in with the setting powder, but just because I was planning on doing a full face of makeup that day. As always, when I'm filming, I'm doing a full face of makeup, so that's why I set my whole face. But to be honest, it wasn't necessary. My skin was already mattified with this foundation mix, so it wasn't really necessary. But anyways, I did my makeup and yes, everything blended pretty well. So overall, I'm really happy with this sunscreen as a makeup base. Now, I did experiment a little bit with my makeup that day, and I do not like my makeup. Oh my god, I hate my makeup in this video, but hopefully the information will compensate for the bad makeup day. Yeah. See you in the final verdict. And now, let me give you my final verdict on this sunscreen. Okay, so as always, I'm going to divide the final verdict into pros and cons. And this one actually only has one con that I cannot even call a con, but you already know where this is going. I really love this sunscreen. I think this is my favorite one out of all Garnier sunscreens that I have tried so far. And yes, I even tried the sensitive one. I'm not happy with it. Here's a little preview of the next video. I'm not happy with it, but you will have to wait for the video to find out why I'm not happy with it. So definitely this one is my fave. I did like the anti-age one, but that one was peeling a little bit, so that's the thing that was bothering people. For me, it wasn't that big of a problem. It was good, but this one does not peel, moisturizes, gives you a glow, but it's not greasy, not heavy, it's lightweight. So this is like a perfect sunscreen for winter for me, and I think I'm going to use this one throughout the winter. I mean, I cannot promise that because I always test out new things, but if I wasn't doing reviews for YouTube, I would use this one throughout the whole winter because it's two in one, moisturizer and sunscreen. You don't need to combine it with a moisturizer. This is enough on its own. It moisturizes, it hydrates, it gives you a glow. No heavy feeling on the skin. It's not heavy, it's not thick, it's not greasy. I love it, and it does not have fragrance, so I'm going to be able to combine it with retinoids. I mean, when I say combine, that means I'm going to use retinoids in the evening and sunscreen in the morning, because retinoids sometimes do increase my skin sensitivity to fragrance products. So the fact that this one does not have fragrance is great. That means that I can use it at the same time when I'm using retinoids in the evening, so that's another great thing. Also, it looks great under underneath makeup. Okay, now those would be the pros, and the only con that I can think of is that you have to kind of blend it really fast to avoid the white cast. It does not give you a white cast, actually. When you first apply it, it is white, but as you are blending it, that disappears, the white cast disappears. So the only thing, as you saw in the demo application, the first time I did apply a lot and it was hard for me to blend it. Now, instead of applying a lot, just like I did the first time, I applied two layers. Apply one normal layer and then apply another one after 10 minutes. And that way you will be sure that you covered your face completely and you did not miss the spots, and it will be easier to blend and avoid that white residue on your face. So yeah, that's like the only con that I can think of, if I can even call it a con. Yeah, that you have to blend it a little bit faster, because once it dries, if the white residue dries, it's going to be a little bit harder to blend it. But again, it's not impossible, so I cannot even call this a con, to be honest. Yeah, I cannot even call it's not a con for me. Like, it can happen if you don't blend it properly, you can have some white residue on your face. So can we call that a con? I'm not sure. Like, it just, you just blend it faster, that's it. Like, it's not a problem really. So yeah, there you have it. If you have been struggling to use the moisturizer and sunscreen at the same time, why would you do that when there is a sunscreen like this? Just saying, you don't have to use two products, a sunscreen and a moisturizer. Just use this sunscreen. It's 2-in-1 moisturizer and sunscreen, and there you go. I think it's going to be great for winter, for dry, and even for normal skin types. Now, would I use it during the summer? Well, because it's not greasy, I think you can get away with this one even throughout the summer, just with a little bit more setting powder on the face to, you know, tone the glow down. But it's of course going to be more useful in winter when you do need that extra moisture. There you have it. There you go. That would be my final verdict on this sunscreen. Let me know if you're going to try it, and thank you so much for watching this video, and I will see you in my next one. Bye!